What's up, guys, and welcome back to a brand new video. If you're new here, then my name is Brianna, but you can call me Bri. And in today's video, I'm going to be telling you which is the best cast net for beach casting. In a beach, you normally catch mullet, maybe a sheep head, and some other tiny baits. And that's pretty much what we catch too. And in this video, you're also going to get to see a very nice trip that we had to the beach, cast netting with my dad and a friend of ours, and we caught a ton of mullet, and we did an amazing catch, clean and cook, and even a sheep head. That was delicious, so I can't wait for you guys to watch that. But first, I'm going to give you a little explanation on which is the best cast net for beach casting. Here we have two cast nets, this one and this one. This cast net is actually from Walmart, and this cast net is custom made. I'm gonna explain to you guys the differences on both and which one is best. Starting off with the Walmart cast net. This Walmart cast net is actually the one that we took to the beach and the one that we caught all our mullet with that day. We also took this one, but our main one was this one. We bought the cast net from Walmart. I'm gonna show you guys a picture of the exact one that we bought. When we bought it, it was $94, but now I think it's like 96, 97. But yeah, you never expect Walmart to be such a good place to catch a cast net, and it's amazing. Here's a closer look at our cast net. I'd say it weighs like 20 pounds, but I'm gonna show you guys what it actually weighs. And it's definitely not a cast net for a kid to throw on a long cast netting trip. It's an adult cast net because it does get heavy in the water. Also, this is a 9-foot cast net, meaning when you stand it up, here it's standing up. When you stand it up, I'm like 5'5", and here's another 4 feet of cast net, I guess. 9 feet on each side, it's got an 18-foot diameter and covers a pretty good amount of space. I actually think I'm gonna go ahead and throw it for you guys can see. I'm not the best thrower, but that's pretty much how it looks. And you guys are gonna get to see it a lot more in the video because this was the one that we used. My dad says the hole size is 3/4, and that's a pretty good size for what we catch, which is basically mullet. But we also use this cast net for casting tilapia. I actually just did a video on cast netting tilapia, and it works great for tilapia too and canal fishing, so it has two uses. Well, overall, this is our main cast net, the one that we use for catching tilapia, mullet, and basically whenever we go cast netting. I'm pretty sure it's in every cast net video, and we buy maybe 2 or 3 of these from Walmart every around a year or so, because sometimes it does get stuck, but it is a very heavy duty cast net. Sometimes we fix holes that it has in it and it can just keep going. We actually fixed the hole the trip that we went last week. That was our last video. And even when these strings right here get unattached from the end of the cast net, we just tie it again. But overall, it's a very heavy duty cast net and it's served us very well. It's caught a ton of fish for us, and this is our main cast net. Now, this one is a recent purchase that we actually made. There is an old man in our neighborhood that did make this cast net for us. He goes fishing a lot, and he used to make cast nets, or I think he still does make cast nets for mackerel fishing. I'm not sure if this was this cast net's purpose, but it still works for the beach great. Also, I forgot to mention, compared to our other cast net, this one is actually a lot lighter than this one, and this one does sink faster, and it does pick up on the floor a lot closer to the ground and doesn't leave a lot of room for the fish to escape. This cast net is 10 feet on each side, so it has a 20-foot diameter. I don't think you're gonna get to see this one in action in the video, but I'll still throw it for you guys. We have used it before and it is a good cast net. It is more comfortable to use since it's a lot lighter and you can last a little more time than you could with our other one. It is lighter, I'd say like 5 pounds lighter, and it does have a wider range and bigger holes, so it does catch bigger fish. I'm not sure if the bigger holes are maybe for the mackerel. Here's an example of the holes. This is also a really great cast net. The only disadvantage is that it does not sink as fast as this one. These are made by an old friend of ours on the block that actually makes huge boats as decorations. We actually have one in the living room that you guys have seen in some videos. Anyways, that's it for the comparison of the two cast nets. Both cast nets are actually really great, but if you want a heavy duty, reliable, and sure to catch fish cast net, then get the $90-something cast net from Walmart. It's great for beach fishing and canal fishing and pretty much anywhere you want to throw it, which makes it an all around good cast net. Well, guys, that's it about explaining about the cast nets. So now I hope you guys enjoy our mullet catch, clean, and cook. We started off our morning at a nearby beach where we did catch one mullet, but it somehow escaped when we pulled up the cast net. Thank you.
A few minutes later.
Well, the castnet's really stuck right now. We waited for the pack of mullet to come over, and then he casted, and he caught like 6. And right now he says there's like 3. But he's trying to get it unstuck because there's a piece of metal or something there in the river. And we don't want to break the castnet, so we're doing it carefully. You got it. No, there's still some good ones in there. Well, it was a mess to get the castnet out of the water and another mess to get it all the way back up the hill. And I'm kind of still going up the hill because there's a ton of rocks and we kept on getting stuck. But we left with 4 really good manatees and...
4 really good manatees.
The word I said was manatees because we were seeing a bunch of them on top of the water, but the word I meant to say was mullet. Hey, look at this ball. We just found it right there. We're gonna go find another spot now though, see if we can catch some more mullet. Oh my gosh, it's a mackerel. Well, we were over there playing with the rods, trying to catch more jacks. Supposed to caught like 10 mullets in one cast.
10.
10 more?
What are you talking about? 25.
Oh. That was a beautiful pancake. We're trying here in the middle of this brownish water. You never know, there could be a ton of fish here. And we've seen them jump. Oh, we got some. Music. We got like 10 again. And they're really good sizes too. Oh my gosh, you got a sheep head. Oh my gosh. We got a nice legal sheep head. It's been a while since we've seen one. She's trying to steal our fish. You want this one? Here they come.
Can you?
We're almost at the brim. There's just a little bit left. For you. Get it. Nice. Get it. Get it. He's trying to figure it out. I'm gonna throw it up in the sand so you can deal with him over there. There he goes. Oh, he took it. Have fun with that. There's your dinner. This is what we finished off with today's afternoon. We almost have the full bucket full of mullet and this beautiful sheep head, which we're gonna enjoy a lot. So we're gonna go ahead and pick these up. We're putting over here the biggest ones that we're gonna cook today and on fire. Look at this one, it's literally 2 feet long. It's the biggest one that we have here. My dad's right over there, he's playing up the mullet and the other fish that we caught so we can cook them here on top of the fire. Here's Coco. We're gonna cook them here on top of the fire, so I'm working on that. Gotta add a little more liquid. And it'll light up slowly. Coco, come say hi. My dad's cleaning the fish that we're gonna cook on the fire right now. He's basically just gonna try to cut it in half so we can lay it down flat. We're gonna wash them really good and take off all the black stuff, but this is basically what they're all gonna look like. My mom is making the sauce for the fish. So what do you have there, mommy?
So basically we have sriracha, black pepper, then we have garlic so far, and then I'm gonna do lemon, salt, and I'm gonna do mayo.
There's the tahini, and now she's adding the lemon. I think that's like 4 lemons. I Okay, so the first thing we did was put this salt on, and it was a pretty good amount of it. You can see there's a good sprinkle there. And now my mom's putting down the sauce that I saw her make. Kind of just trying to put it everywhere on all the fishes. Like this. Now we put this thin looking mesh over it, and we're taking these little pieces of cable, and we're just gonna secure it down together.
A few minutes later.
And that's gonna finish off today's video, guys. I did forget to finish the video, but trust me, the mullet and the sheep head were delicious. I actually got to eat the sheep head, and it was really good. We are going to make that recipe again as soon as we go cast netting again, because it's delicious and everybody really liked it. And I suggest you try it yourself, because it's actually pretty easy. And like I said, delicious. Anyways, thank you so much for watching today's video. And if you enjoyed, please make sure to like, subscribe down below. It's totally free and I would really appreciate it. We're almost at 500 subscribers and we post videos every single week. Thank you so much for watching and I'll see you guys next week. Bye.